Today we're going to be talking about 8.1 ratios. Go ahead and write this down for me. A ratio is a comparison of two numbers. And we're going to talk about three different ways that you can write a ratio. The three different ways to write a ratio, this first one right here that you can see says A to B. Okay, so you just read it simply A to B. This one right here, it doesn't look like that, but it still means A to B. It just has a colon in between them. And this last one, guess how you might read that?
Fresh.
A to B, the same exact way, okay? So in reading a ratio, A to B is how you read all of them. There's one specific one that we are going to use in our class every time. I want you to circle it with your red pen. We are always going to use the fraction bar, A over B, but it's still read A to B. Number one says, the table shows the wins and losses of three different teams. Use the table to write the specified ratio for the Chicago Cubs. What are the names of the three teams that you see there? Okay, so do you see here that we've got some wins and losses? How many wins did the Dodgers have?
18.
18, you can see it right there. How many losses did the San Diego Padres have?
11.
Okay, so that's just kind of helping us interpret the chart there. As we're looking at it now, you can see also not just the wins and losses, but you could figure out how many games total that they had. If you're looking at the San Diego Padres, they have 16 wins and 11 losses. How can I figure out how many total games they played?
27.
Add them together. 16 plus 11. How many did they play?
27.
Okay, 27, all right? All you did is you just added those two together, and that found us the total number of games that they had. So right now, we're going to go ahead and look at A. This asks us to write a ratio for the wins to losses. Now, what we're going to do each time, whenever we have a chance to write the ratio, every single time, we are going to go ahead and use it in a fraction form, okay? So we're going to go ahead and write our ratio today in fraction form. Wins to losses. How many wins did the Chicago Cubs have?
17.
So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and write 17 on top, okay? And how many losses did the Chicago Cubs have?
14.
So as you can see, the wins we write first and the losses we will write second because we're just reading it from left to right. Now, every single time you are going to want to reduce your answer. Can I reduce or can I make 17 over 14 any more simple?
No.
No, I cannot. So go ahead and box your answer in because the answer is 17 to 14 is their wins to losses. Now problem B asks us to write a ratio for the wins to games played. So how many wins did the Chicago Cubs have?
They had 17 wins.
You can see it right there. So I'm going to write 17 first. Now it asks me, how many games did they play?
31.
How'd you find that? You added the wins and losses together. So the ratio is 17 to 31. Can I make that any more simple? No, there is absolutely nothing that can go into a 17 that can also go into a 31. So that's how you write a ratio. Every time it's going to be in fraction form. And just remember, always read from left to right. Whatever it says first, you'll write down first or on top. And then the other one you'll write down second or on bottom. So let's go ahead and do this for number two. Write the ratio as a fraction in simplest form. As you can see, problem A says 9 over 15. Is that already like a fraction, yes or no?
Yes,
it is. Okay, now is it in simplest form?
No.
No. What can go into a 9 that can also go into a 15?
3.
Okay, so you're going to divide by 3 on the top and divide by 3 on the bottom. When you do that, what do you get?
3/5.
Can anything go into a 3 that can also go into a 5?
No.
So that is as simple as it gets, and that's your answer, 3 to 5, or 3/5. Let's go to the next one, problem B. It says 8 to 5. I want this ratio to be written not as 8 to 5, but as a fraction. So how would I do that?
8 over 5.
Can that be reduced at all?
No.
No. There is nothing that goes into an 8 that also goes into a 5, so that is your answer. The next one, it says 32 to 48. How do I write that as a fraction? 32 over 48. Now I want you to come up with how to get that into simplest form. Who can help me out with what can go into a 32 and a 48? What do you think?
16.
Okay, she says 16.
Me too.
When you did a 16, what did you get? She got 2/3. Who would say that you did something different than divide by a 16? Mason, what'd you do?
8.
Okay, so you did 32 48s divided by 8 on top and 8 on bottom. When you did that, what did you get?
4 over 6.
And then did you reduce that anymore?
Yes.
Okay, and what did you reduce that by?
2.
Okay, and when you divided by 2 on top and bottom, what did you get?
2/3.
So basically what this is saying is, I do not care how you get your answer. Your goal just is to get the same simplest form fraction at the end. Did anyone do anything different than divide by 16 or divide by 8 and 2? What'd you do?
I did divide by 4.
Okay, you divided by 4, and then you had to divide, I'm guessing, by...
Yeah. No. Oh, yeah. I divided by 4, and I got 8 over 12, and I reduced it to 4 over 6, and then I reduced it to 2.
Okay, so here's the deal. One thing, she did divide by 16... It went a little bit faster, but I do not care, once again, how you get there. You could have divided by 8 and then divided by 2, or divided by 4 and then 4. As long as you get it in simplest form, the answer should be 2/3. So with a ratio, you just want to make sure every time you always reduce it to simplest form. Number 3. You're going to have a problem just like this on your homework tonight. It says, which ratio is not equivalent to 14 to 14? So I've got 4 different options here, and one of them is not going to be equivalent. Whenever I have something like this, 14 to 4, how am I going to write it?
14 over 4.
As a fraction, 14 over 4. All right, so for that 14 over 4, how would I write that in more simple form? Divide by what?
2.
Okay, divide by 2 on top and bottom. What do you get?
7 over 2.
So the main thing is I want all of these to work out like this, 7 over 2. The first one, how would I write that fraction?
2 over 7.
Problem B, it says 14 to 4. How would I write that fraction?
7 over 2.
Okay, you can divide by 2, and that equals 7 over 2. The next one, 7 to 2. How would I write that as a fraction?
7 over 2.
The last one, how do I write this as a fraction? 28 over 8. What can go into a 28 that can also go into an 8?
4.
A 4. When I divide that, what do I get?
7 over 2.
So looking at that and all of my answers, which one is not equivalent to 14 to 4?
A.
2 to 7. All right? 2 over 7 is flipped. That's the opposite. So when you do your homework tonight, you're going to kind of do it like that. Figure out which one is not equivalent to the original problem that they give to you. Tonight's homework is 8.1. There's just 10 problems for tonight, and this is everything you need to know for 8.1 ratios.